Hello everyone, it's Troy here from Tennis Warehouse, and today I wanted to give you a quick breakdown on how to customize your racket and with a certain amount of weight, how that'll affect the specs of your racket regarding weight, balance, and swing weight. We've done quite a few videos already on how to customize, why customize your racket, how adding weight in specific locations will change the performance. Today I'm gonna get into more details on a small amount of weight and how that affects the specs overall. To start things off with adding weight, I'm gonna talk about strategic places in the hoop of the racket or in the head of the racket. At 12 o'clock, we've done a video on adding weight to the tip of the racket before, but when you add weight to the tip of the racket 12 o'clock, you're gonna maximize power, increase the swing weight the most with the least amount of weight. So that's plow through and power at the very tip. 3 and 9 o'clock, that's gonna maximize the stability or torsional stability of the frame and also maximize the twist weight. And then 10 and 2 o'clock is sort of a hybrid between those two locations, basically giving you a little bit added torsional stability and also getting further towards the tip of the racket to increase that swing weight and that plow through. So what I'm gonna do just as a quick example is take one of these strips here of our Tennis Warehouse tungsten tape. Each one of these strips is 3 grams. They're 8 inches long and there's 3 strips. In one package, you got a total of 9 grams. So for today, I'm just gonna use a 3 gram piece right here, and I'm gonna show you what it does to each location. So if I were to take this 8-inch strip and cut it right in half, I'm gonna end up with 2 4-inch strips. And if I were gonna add this to 12 o'clock, I'd put a strip at the top, I'd center it, one on each side of the frame, like one on that side, and I'd use the other one, put it there. That's gonna add 3 grams to your racket. It's gonna increase the swing weight by about 10 points on average at the 12 o'clock location. And it's also gonna make the racket 1 point less head light or 1 point more head heavy, whatever the reference balance point is. So that's 12 o'clock location. All right, moving your way down the head of the racket, we're gonna move to the 3 and 9 o'clock location, which maximizes torsional stability. What I would do in this case, I have my 2 4-inch strips, the 1 8-inch strip I cut in half. I would actually take these 2 strips and cut these in half, making it 4 pieces of about 2 inches long. And then from there, I would place 1 strip on each side at the 3 and 9 o'clock location. And then this is just a quick reference. It's not perfectly matched up, but flip it over and then also add my other 2 strips to the other side of the string plane, giving me 4 strips total. 3 grams total. And basically what this will do is this is gonna increase your swing weight by about 5 to 6 points. And it's gonna actually be about a half balance point, either less head light or more head heavy, a total of 3 grams. So if I take that same amount of weight I added at 3 and 9 o'clock, 3 grams total, 4 2-inch strips of the tungsten tape, and I place them at the 10 and 2 o'clock on the racket. So basically I'd place one right about this region here on the frame, another one mirroring the on the other side, so 10 and 2, 2 and 10, whatnot. And then I flip the racket over and put the other 2 pieces on those same spots, so you have 4 pieces total. That's going to increase your swing weight by about 7 to 8 points, and it's going to be about three-fourths of a balance point, either less head light or more head heavy, giving you a total of 3 grams at 10 and 2. When adding weight to the middle of the racket, the throat region of the racket, you're basically increasing the weight without really changing the balance point because you're putting the weight near the balance point of the racket. So to do that, I have my 8-inch strip cut in half, the 2 4-inch strips, and basically I'm just gonna lay them in the middle of the yoke on each side. Basically 1 strip there, flip it over, and I'd add another strip here. So basically adding 3 grams to the racket, not really affecting the balance point because you're adding the weight near the center where the balance point is. As far as swing weight goes, it's pretty minimal. It's usually about 1 to 2 points increase in swing weight in this area. Now we've worked our way down all the way to the bottom of the racket towards the butt cap. Usually when adding weight inside the handle, we use our Tennis Warehouse tungsten putty. This stuff's very dense. There's a whole ounce of putty in here. So in order to get 3 grams from this, I would open it up, take the tungsten putty out, and I would just need a very small piece. But basically, we have a video already on how to tell weight your racket. You use a little bit of cotton, a little bit of the putty, take the trapdoor out and put the 3 grams inside the handle. What that's gonna do is gonna add 3 grams to your racket. It's gonna make your racket 1 point more head light or 1 point less head heavy. And it's gonna have really no effect on swing weight. Very, very minimal, not enough for our RDC machine to pick up to be a whole swing weight point. But the more weight you add in there, eventually it will increase the swing weight somewhat, but just 3 grams right inside the butt cap at the very bottom where you hold the racket, no effect on swing weight. Lastly, for adding weight, I oftentimes get the question how the leather grip replacement affects the specs of the racket somewhat. So if you were to take off the stock grip on your racket, add a leather grip, we do have a video on how to put on a replacement grip. The leather grip on average, it varies from brand and different manufacturers, different thicknesses, but just on average, it's about 8 to 10 grams increase to the handle, and you're adding the weight throughout the handle. It's not located just in one spot. And that's gonna make the racket about 2 points more head light or 2 points less head heavy. And the swing weight effect is pretty minimal. It's usually about 1 point increase in swing weight, maybe a point and a half. I hope this helps you out with some at-home customization of your rackets. We have more information and details with an article in our Learning Center under Customize a Racket from our customization guru, Paul Reed. And for more videos like this or anything tennis related, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only.